The Unexpected.
It's kind of cozy, really, isn't it? I don't think you could call it a hardship, this social distancing.
We don't even have to get dressed if we don't want to. Build a fire in the wood stove. Pass me a crumpet, Margot.
Must be over a month since you've seen anybody. We don't even see the grocery delivery person anymore.
We speak to them on the phone.
Well, yes. Just arrange the dropping off point. Since they won't come up the driveway now.
Well, they don't always get it right, though, do they?
Where did they drop it this week?
In that boggy area down by the pond. It was damned annoying. It took me hours to get the mud off my rubber boots.
It was the 9 bags of crumpets that really got my goat. And the 23 green peppers.
Still, you made that ratatouille. Although it was a bit, what you might call, mono-savorous.
Well, what could I do? They'd substituted every vegetable I ordered with green peppers.
Definitely not multi-flavorful. More on a single note, really. Light-bodied. Still, it must have been worse during the war.
Exactly. We've got crumpets to toast and wine to drink. I am so enjoying all these vintages you've laid down. Very forward-thinking of you, I'd say.
Oh, thank you. Although I didn't put them down with a global pandemic in mind.
No. What's that?
The doorbell.
I know that, Gerald. But what's making it ring? It's dark and cold and we're self-isolating.
Well, it can't be Phyllis and Jonathan. Unless they're being exceptionally neighbourly, they're supposed to be isolating too.
If it was an emergency, they'd call us.
Unless the line's down.
Check the phone.
There's a dial tone. There's definitely somebody there.
We can't open the door if we're physically distancing. Look through the curtains.
I could see a shadow. It's moving slightly.
Maybe it's a bear.
Leaning on the doorbell? We'd hear it snuffling. Anyway, they're still in hibernation. They don't even know there's a crisis going on.
Well, they wouldn't anyway, would they?
What?
Even if they were awake, lumbering about, looking for food, they wouldn't know what was going on in the world, would they?
I suppose not.
Although they might notice something was up. What with more people at home during the day, filling up the bird feeders, breaking the ice on the bird baths.
No, it's definitely too early for bears to surface. They're still asleep.
Maybe that's what we should all do.
What?
Sleep through this crisis. Just turn off, get into bed, lower our body temperatures, ignore doorbells, and only get up for the occasional food forage.
Has anybody suggested it?
I don't think so. Gerald, don't answer that door.
I think I'm just going to listen. Maybe I could push a note under.
What would it say?
Who are you? What do you want? We are in isolation. Go away!
Okay.
Something already came in under the door. Onto the mat. Look.
I think I am lost.
Is that all it says?
Hmm.
Well, how can they be lost? What are they doing wandering about in our woods?
Maybe they're hunting.
It's not hunting season. We've got all those no hunting signs.
They could be cross-country skiing.
At 10 o'clock at night?
We got lost once at Mont Orford when dusk fell and we were off-piste.
Well, this person's definitely off-piste. Or, as you might say, pieced off.
You know, Gerald, this doesn't ring true. It's probably a trick. This is a remote location.
We're lucky to get a postal delivery.
I wonder why they didn't leave the note in our mailbox.
Well, because it's at the end of the driveway, round a blind corner, across the road and hanging from someone else's tree.
It's got our number painted on it.
If they knew the number, they wouldn't be lost.
It could be the fire department.
Not on fire.
Just checking things are okay. Routine inspection.
Margot, it's only essential services right now.
But they are essential.
I know. Anyway, they'd have already kicked the door in.
How about an ambulance? Come to the wrong house. I'll bet there's a lot of that right now, with 911 being manned by volunteers.
We'd have heard the siren coming up the driveway, and they'd be banging on the door by now. You know what those brutes are like? I'm going to try shouting through the door.
They won't hear you. There's too much insulation. It'll be all muffled.
Not too much. Just a code.
I suppose you could tell by their voices if they're a man or woman.
What difference would that make?
Less threatening if it's a woman.
But just as infectious.
Look through the window again. Are they wearing a mask?
I still can't see properly. It's just a shadow.
Well, is the shadow wearing a mask?
Maybe.
Right. So, mask and snorkel. There you go. Well,
but it's yellow, Margot.
That's good. Means you can be seen. Spray bottle. Take the big one.
I'd better wear gloves.
Take the fire gloves. Here. Now, let me look at you. Oh, yes, you definitely look like you mean business. Count to 20 if you open the door. If you open the door, count to 20. I heard it on the radio. It's the amount of time it takes for infected droplets to fall to the ground. Yes, it's like singing happy birthday when you wash your hands. Look, there's drops. They don't just hover in suspended animation, do they? I mean, they have to go somewhere. It's the law of gravity. Gerald?
Phew. Margot? Did you order a pizza?
Is it vegetarian?
Green pepper. It's still hot.
Let me see. Oh, yum.
Margot?
Have some, Gerald. A little provender. Before we hibernate.
Just like the bears.
The Unexpected was written by Marilyn Bullivant, with Rick Davey as Gerald and Marilyn Bullivant as Margaret.